Hello, my name is Scott for SB Gaming. Welcome back to Betrayer. We're here in Fort Hope, and in the last episode, I think we came in through here. We explored this area, got all the clues, all the notes, all the chests, or at least most of the chests. We have a few chests up there. We actually do have the shovel now. We found it over in this area, so we can actually dig up all the buried treasure as well. And I think in the last episode, I did want to go into the other world and explore the various, the race and the, there's a bunch of them here, race in the shadows. But I am going to head up and I'm just going to clear some of these chests and buried treasure. So we are going to head off in this direction. And depending on how long it takes, I'll probably go into the other world. Alright, so, yep, we want to head roughly north. And there is a totem. And it is shrouded in corruption, so what we're going to have to do is go into the other world, come over here, there'll be enemies that'll pop up. All those spores. Alright. Now I'm going to head further north. Coins. There's another one off in this direction. Oh. Oh dear. Alright, how about that? And yeah. So yeah, there's these spider creatures. The big one took a big shot from the was the musket. Be off in that direction. Now. Yeah, it's. They're really hard to see. I'm going to want the. Grab the pistol. And reload. Reload. All right. Let's go back to our. Actually, before I do, yep, reload our musket. And a common charm of vigor. Here's a question. I have a crude charm of vigor, which I'm using right now. Health increased by 10%. Nice. Let's put that on. And that upgrades our hit points to 110. I was sitting at 105. All right, I need to go straight west. And one thing I probably shouldn't be doing is running. Alright, about that. Away. Yeah, I know where I am now. Seeing things. Not really. Let's run. Oh, nice. So the pistol actually does pretty decent damage. The difference between the two, though, was that the pistol is very short range. Musket is moderate range. So yeah, about that. And let's drink. Explosive. All right, so it's off in this direction. Tomahawk harness. Oh, nice. So this give me a couple extra. Looks like it. All right, so we need to head south. All And that's another thing. I should be using my bombs and, if I remember which they are. Hang on just a moment. Alright, G is Tomahawk, and B is Explosives. Oh. And we have Warrior Shortbow. This does 70 damage, range short, speed very fast. Special is stealthy. Sell price is 1,000. Alright, damage 70. Yeah, I'd say so. Holy shortbow. Wow. Range is short though. You know what? I'm going to. Quality longbow is 45 damage. Warrior shortbow. Interesting. We are going to. I'm going to put into the. Second slot. So that is the quality longbow, and that is the warrior's shortbow. Now, if I'm not mistaken, right around this area is another set of spiders. They were right around here. Came up to the chest. They were over there. I don't know if they were a random spawn or a placed enemy. Journal updated, all treasure chests found. Alright, so what I'm going to do is return back to Fort Hope. And actually, yeah, when I come back through here, I'll dig these up. So I won't need to do that. Yeah, we're going to go to Fort Hope. And now, we want to go to the other world. But first, I have 1,733... an exceptional pistol. Purchase. Longbow quiver. Shortbow quiver. Yep, I'm gonna get both of those. Crossbow quiver. I'm going to need and we're going to fill up with arrows. Pistol load, I'm definitely going to want to refill my ammo and the musket load. Down to 833. And explosives, 100. So we have Common Charm of Grace, 8% harder to hear and see. Crude Charm of Grace, 4%. Common Charm of Swiftness, come 4% harder to hear and see. Move 6% faster. Go to our inventory, and what I would like to do, we have a common charm of ferocity. I think I'm going to just sell this. How much is it worth? 300? Yep. And then the common charm of vigor. Yep. Oh, wait a minute. Did I not? Okay, well, I'm going to sell the crude charm. So, yeah, my health should be back up to 110. Multi Charm of Ferocity. Nope, that's fine. Alright. Water Barrel. And health of 110. Alright, well, at this point, what I'm going to do, ring the bell. Oh dear. Oh dear. Silver Skull. Well, this bow definitely is nice and powerful, although they're still not one-hit kills. Alright, let's drink up. And now we got, there is Wraith here? No, there's a Shadow. And he is right about here. Nope. Yeah, right in here. So we'll need to find one of the Wraiths in order to be able to make him show up. And we are going to head head to the south. Singing heading north. That must be that deflect chance. Because I didn't do any damage to them at all. And where are we right now? All right, southeast. And there we are. And Wraith, do you not hear the screams? Terrible, wretched screams. I do not. Strange, they have fallen silent. Or could it be that I dreamed them? My dreams are troubled of late. Where am I? How did I come to be here? The sound of the bell will guide you home. Okay. And what I'd like to do next, we are going to head to the east. So roughly that direction. And while I'm there, Silver Skull. All right, this way. Somewhere around here. ambush around here. Unless he's a shadow. I think you have to discover the race first before the shadows reveal themselves. I think that's how it works. But yeah, he would be right around here. What I'd like to do while I'm here is head to this totem, which is roughly in that direction. Actually, this is where the shadow would be. This person here. And there is the totem. Shrouding corruption. Oh, wow. And the corruption is gone. And the reason I'm doing these is because in the early level, for those who've watched the early level, we had to reveal the corruption or cure the corruption in order to proceed. It has been cleansed of corruption. Alright, so now we can go back there. So gonna head in a southwest direction and I'll meet you over there. Alright, well, another one. Oh. Oh dear. Let's drink. Let's reload. Alright, about that. Alright, where was I? Yeah, I'm using up ammo. Oh wow, heading in the wrong direction. Ah, there we are. And yeah, I'm kind of running around and allowing them to see me. But let's go in this direction. Oh dear. Reload. worried about that. Well, I'm going to have to purchase some ammo. Yeah, that was a... Let's purchase a few of those. Purchase a few of those. Oh! Oh, bother. What did I purchase? Pistol load. Oh, did I buy some more? Oh, wow. Now I'm not. Yeah, I'm right empty. So what I'm going to do... inventory. Do I have anything I can sell? Not really. I might keep this. And the Maiden Red. It was here that I last saw my sister. I remember waking in the darkness. I felt her trembling beside me and realized she was crying. She wouldn't tell me why. She said I wouldn't understand. The next morning she was gone. No one had seen her. There was no trace of her. She never would have left without telling me she would have said goodbye. All right about that. I was frightened to move here, but I found I was happier here than Fort St. George, for a while at least. And she is not. Alright, well, at this point, what I'm going to do is take a break here. That was an interesting stint into the other world, and yeah, I got a little bit overwhelmed there. Ran out of water, trying to make my way over here. I really should... Actually, no, it doesn't really matter if you sneak your way across the area or run across, because if you get close, they'll pop out anyway, although... They won't necessarily, I don't think, spot you. So it's not necessarily that bad. But yeah, I might have to reconsider my lineup because reasons. If we go to inventory. I kind of like having my pistol. Thing with the short bow. There's a deflect chance of 20%. That's the thing. When you're up close, you don't want your shot to deflect. Although, with that said, deflect chance 0%. Actually, that's nice. Although, yeah, exceptional musket deflect chance of 5%. Well, I'm going to have to think about it. I'm probably going to go with this lineup. I kind of like the quality longbow, although, yeah. Anyway, at this point, I'm going to take a break here, and we'll continue on with the next episode of Betrayer. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for watching. My name is Scott for SB Gaming, and as always, have a good day.